Right. So we're going to talk about our sexual response cycle today, and how you can actually incorporate our parties to talk about the sexual health response cycle, and also to sell our products at the same time, and how it's going to help. Because we are here in the business to educate and empower women, correct? Right. Okay. So we have the amazing array of products to be able to do that at the same time. So I want to first start off with, there's five phases. Currently, with the new, everything being updated and stuff, they say there's only four, but I believe that there is still five, okay? So I'm going to see if I can get this going here. All right, so we're gonna start here. This is what it's, and then here you can have this, and then here, okay? So the six phases are, the first one is your desire, okay? Your second one is your excitement. Your third one is your plateau. I think I spelled it right. Then up here, you have your climax. And then this is where your multiple orgasms come into play, okay? And then you have your resolution, all right? So these are the six. So the new studies show that desire does not exist anymore, and it just starts with your excitement, okay? So with these six phases, all right, your desire to want to have sex, the desire that you want to be with your partner, the desire that you want to be intimate, for me, really starts within yourself. So you have to feel sexy. You have to feel wanted. It all really starts with you. And as every time that I start with my parties, sexy is not a size, it's an attitude. It's how you perceive yourself. It's how you feel about yourself to the world. Because if you feel like you're not sexy, are you going to have sex, or are you going to have really good sex? Not really, right? So it really starts with us and our beauty care line, all right? So the second stage is your excitement. So after you have your desire, now you've got this excitement going on, all right? And what happens in your excitement stage happens to both men and women. So the sexual response cycle right here happens to both men and women, just FYI, all right? So on your excitement, what happens in this section, your muscle tension increases, your heart rate quickens, and your breathing is accelerated. Your skin may become flushed, all right? Your nipples become hardened or erect. Blood flow to the genitals also increase. So swelling of our clitoris, the labia, the minora, and also this is where the erection happens in a man. So this is also where your vaginal lubrication starts to begin, all right? The woman's breast also becomes fuller, and the vaginal walls begin to swell. And also, this is where, for the men, his testicles swell, his scrotum tightens, and he also might begin excreting lubrication, okay? Which is basically what we call pre-cum, right? So this is your excitement stage. And in your excitement stage is where a lot of times we might need to really help enhance this area here. So as far as one of the things I've already talked about, this is the excitement stage is where a woman starts her vaginal lubrication process. So if there's no excitement, it's a wham, bam, thank you, man. Obviously, there is no lubrication happening. Right? So definitely a little bit of lubrication at the very beginning is perfect to also to prevent your tearing in your scar tissue. And this is also where foreplay is vital as well. All right. So your excitement is also / foreplay is what I would call that. So I'm going to put another text here. I'm going to change the color to here. I'm going to AKA foreplay. All right. All right. And now the phase two is after you are excited, you get to go to the plateau stage. And everyone's plateau is different. Some are very short, some are very long before they get to the climax. For most women, it is long. So remember, an average time for a man to have his orgasm is what? Mm-hmm. Few minutes, right? Anywhere from 30 seconds to 3 to 5 minutes. For a woman, it's about 21 minutes, right? So that's where the plateau, this line could be longer or it could also be shorter. But in your plateau stage, basically what happens in your excitement stage, everything is intensified. So this is where your vagina continues to swell from increased blood flow, all right? Your vaginal walls will start turning a little dark purple. The woman's clitoris becomes highly sensitive, may even be painful to touch. So what happens in this side is because it's so highly sensitive and there's so much blood rushing through there, it actually starts retracting and hiding underneath the clitoral hood. All right. So which means it's hiding, which means you're not going to get off as fast because it's hiding under some extra skin, right? The man's testicles are withdrawn all the way up to the scrotum. So they start drawing inward into their body. Your breathing, your heart rate, and your blood pressure does still continue to increase. You might start experiencing muscle spasms, and also your tension in your muscles increase as well. Okay. So in this stage, as you can tell, you have your plateau. This is a side where you're like, oh my God, everything feels so good. Everything feels so good, but I can't seem to get off. I don't know why. Like, come on now. I can feel it. You can feel it. It's like this tension that's building that for some women, it never happens. Okay. Or he gets off before you do, and then nothing else is done afterwards. All right. So this is where you'll need your enhancements of our product. All right. Oh, in your desire, this is our like the beauty. Okay. All right. Now, after you've reached your plateau and completed, now you have your climax, right? Now, this phase is usually the shortest of all of the phases, right? Because your orgasm doesn't last for hours or minutes. It's usually pretty much seconds, right? Mm. So in your orgasm phase, you have involuntary muscle contraction, all right? Your blood pressure, your heart rate, and your breathing are at the highest rates with rapid intake of oxygen. Muscles in your feet spasm. There's a sudden forceful release of sexual tension, basically your ejaculation and also your man's ejaculation, right? In women, the muscles of the vagina contract. The uterus also undergoes rhythmic contractions. Same thing in the man. It does the same thing in his penis as well. And you have the release tension. La! Right? All right. So this is our ultimate goal is right here in your climax. Okay. And then of course down here you have your, where you can kind of calm down a little bit before you can start orgasming again. So this is where your multiple orgasms can come into play. But if you have it go all the way down to the resolution down here first, then it's going to be really hard for you to get back up here. So you have to kind of like halfway or partway or within a few seconds to keep going over. So that way you can have your multiple orgasms. Within 30 seconds, not 30 minutes, 30 seconds of your orgasm, in order to achieve your multiple orgasms, you have to keep some kind of stimulation still happening. So nipple stimulation, touching your clitoris, caressing, going back into a massage, or something along those lines to keep the blood flow surfacing to our skin. So therefore, everything is still kind of almost like in a dormant stage to where you can go back and orgasm again, right? Otherwise, if you just lay in bed and you're like for a few minutes, it's going to be really hard for you to go back up and start orgasming again without starting all over again, okay? So a study done in 2006 found that sexual arousal in about 82% of young females and 52% of young males arises or is enhanced by direct stimulation of the nipples. Mm-hmm. So a nipple stimulation is a really good way to kind of get the sexual arousal going. All right. And only about 7 to 8% reporting that it actually decreases their arousal. All right. So there are some people that don't like their nipples to be played with or touched that actually decreases it. For the majority though, nipples is one of our highest erogenous zones on our body. So that completely and totally makes sense. All right. So now we have all of this. So your desire, which is your beauty products. So you can actually tailor your party around the sexual response cycle. So first talk about the sexual response cycle, that there are 5 phases to it, all right? The first one is going to be your desire, which is your beauty, everything about us. How do we feel? What makes us feel sexy? Because let's face it, no one wants rough, scaly skin, right? No, all right? Neither does your partner. So they want soft, sexy skin. And plus, if you have rough skin, you have tough tissue, or your skin is tough, which means it's actually covering up your nerve receptors. You're not going to be able to feel the touch and the senses as much as if you had soft, sexy skin. So this is where, so a few items that you can show in your desire in the beauty section is, of course, your first is your body boost, right? It tightens and firms. Gets rid of cellulite, no more hail damage. It's perfectly safe all over your body. And plus, it's going to make you look younger. It kind of seems like it clears your, evens out your complexion, tone as well. It's not greasy and it smells great, and you only need a little bit. All right? Because no one wants flabby skin, right? You want the tight skin so that way you feel sexy as well. Then, of course, you have your Save My Skin, right? Save My Skin is perfect for to help diminish your stretch marks. So no more red or blue or black stretch marks or anything like that. Your Save My Skin is perfect for that. And also anyone that is pregnant, it helps create elasticity in your skin to prevent you from getting future stretch marks. Right? So as women, both of these is probably one of our top things that we are worried about. I don't have smooth skin. I don't have soft skin. I got all of these stretch marks all over my body. I don't feel sexy, yada, da, da. So these are going to help with that, so that way we can become more comfortable with our bodies, all right? Next, you have your Revive. Okay, your Revive is good, so that way those heels, if you have rough skin or dry skin because maybe you have to wash your hands all the time because of work or whatnot, it holds up 400 times its water weight. So it's going to really hydrate and moisturize your skin. It get rid of your scaly heels and stuff within 5 days, depending if that's like the worst case scenario. All right. So I wanted to kind of make this interactive, but I don't know how many people are actually on. But so real quick, I'm just kind of going to go through these because you know what they are. So coochie, right? No rashes, no bumps. No one likes rashes or bumps, right? Because they're like, oh, you're having a great night and you're like, this is gross. And they're like, oh, can I have sex with you? Or should I take her to the doctor? I don't really know. This feels gross. And it almost can kind of turn them off too, right? So rash-free shaving cream or coochie, right? Of course, then you have to protect it with your skin therapy. And then your body wash. And then you have your body do, right? So soft, sexy skin in a bottle is right here. And you smell great. You smell sexy because no one wants to stink, right? So your body do in this, your body washes, and then you have your kiss, right? So your pheromone body mist spray, so that way everything smells great and it's alcohol free. It's perfect. It's great for your hair and or anywhere else. Okay. And then your perfume, right? Yeah. So this is the best thing ever. And it has jasmine and grapefruit in it, which is scientifically known to make you look and feel up to 10 years younger. So you're going to feel fun and flirty whenever you wear this perfume, which is also going to enhance everything that you need in the bedroom, right? Right. Okay. All right. And then men have to feel sexy too, because remember, the sexual response cycle is the same thing for the man. Men have to feel sexy. They have to feel wanted. They don't want to stink either, right? So, of course, we have our men's line, right? Megan smell like Channing Tatum or Christian Grey or whatever, okay? Matthew Conaughey, whatever it is, okay? Floats your fantasy. Make him smell sexy, sexier than what he already is, right? So this is just going to enhance that, and find a scent that you love the best and spray it on him, because that's what's going to get you to the desire and faster to the excitement stage for you, right? And then, of course, he don't like bumps and rashes either on his face or whenever he manscapes. It's the same scenario for the man. They might feel uncomfortable with their rashes or irritations that they get from shaving too, okay? And then, of course, you have your body wash. And then most importantly is your talc. No one likes stinky, sweaty balls.
No.
Right? No, right? They don't like stinky, sweaty balls either. It's really gross for them. So let them feel sexy and let them feel clean and refreshed and all that stuff. So that way they feel desirable too, right? So that is all, basically all your beauty products. And of course, everything else in the beauty products, you know, like your lip glosses, go into that, all of that stuff. So but show the things that you want to show in that section. All right. Then you're going to be like, all right, girls. So now what was it? Does anybody remember what the second stage of the sexual response cycle is? Okay. Get your people involved, get your clients involved into the party, and have them start learning as well. So let them know what the sexual response cycle is and what it can do for them. Or maybe they can then see, oh, I need to really work on the desire stage. I need to really work on the excitement stage. This is where whenever I'm in my bedroom, I'm having trouble with, right? This is really going to help them. So excitement is your foreplay, okay? Your foreplay is where your massages come in. The burning desire is a perfect example. Between the sheets, 9 p.m., right? You can put sharp. You can put get naked now, whatever it is that you want to write on there, right? And, of course, then it turns into your oil for a massage, right? Any of our massage oil products or massage aids that we have is perfect in this section right here. Now, in the excitement stage, remember here, it's here to get your blood flow increased. It's getting everything turned on, all your blood flow now rushing to your genital areas, and massage is a perfect way to enable that. That's why you hear a lot of times, how about a happy ending or whatever, right? Because your body is fully is almost kind of aroused to a, because all your blood flow is rushing to those areas. So having a massage is perfect. Plus you have the intimacy connection between you and your partner too. And of course, then you have these amazing gloves. Yes. Okay. The two-sided gloves. All right. Also in your excitement stage is where you can incorporate your wit. Fun, edible, flavorful, that doesn't taste bad, doesn't leave a bad taste. So at my parties, I always tell them, with the whipped, put them in 5 places of your body that you like to be kissed, your erogenous zones, nipples, sucked, whatever it is, okay? 5 places, you're going to put them in your spots. You're going to tell them, hey, baby, try to find all 5. But you're only going to put 4. Right? So let them keep searching and searching and searching. And this is going to get us super duper excited. And really what it does, it starts preheating our oven to increase natural lubrication for us. Right? So that's where your whip is kind of going to come into play for that. Okay? And then you also have your between the sheets. By this point in time, maybe you might be sweating, getting a little too excited, whatnot. Because maybe then you are doing other things that maybe you're not used to doing. You might give them some great head at this point in time, right? So this is all of your excitement stage that kind of gets everything going at a faster rate, okay? Now, if he gets too excited, this is the stage that you want to put the up all night. Right? So that way he doesn't become the 30-second man. So this right here, that way it's going to last longer, because remember, we have that gap between the time that we can orgasm by the time they can, to where up all night is going to help desensitize them a little bit to where you can achieve your orgasm, maybe even at the same time. Also in this stage is where you want to do your sexy spreader, your bed bondage and beyond, to even get things a little bit more heated and a little bit more excited, right? Okay, and of course, you can't forget your blindfold, right? So this is where all of these products here, all of your 50 Shades of Grey products, your bondage products come into play, is in your excitement stage, okay? Oh, same thing with your sensations as well, all right? Okay, now in your plateau stage, remember everything is now, it's hiding, like your clitoris is hiding underneath this clitoral hood. This is where you're at that stage, you're like, oh my gosh, I'm almost there. What do I need to do? Like, what's happening? This is where your enhancement creams come into play. So your AMP, your O, your Pure, your Boost, okay? These are the ones that's going to increase the extra blood flow to the clitoral area, so that way it can pop right back out of your clitoral hood. So that way it's no longer in hiding, so you can achieve your orgasm faster, stronger. And this is also what's going to give you those multiple orgasms after you finally climax, because the AMP is going to bring it fast, the O is going to keep it there, okay? So therefore, after you climax, as long as you don't wait too long, this is still going to keep that blood flow in your clitoris to where you can have your multiple orgasms, okay? Also in the plateau stage, you might want to note is where your body actually stops producing lubrication. So if your plateau stage is a little long to where then you almost feel like you're kind of drying up and you have to add more lube, this is also where you want to show your lubricants, okay? So, because no one wants that dry vaginal sex, especially when everything was going and then it kind of disappears. So you're Just Like Me, you're Simply Silk, you're Pure Pleasure. These are the ones that you want to use in that plateau stage to make things better, right? All right, then you have your climax. Woo-hoo, right? In your climax, after here, this is where you can talk about your toys. This is where you're going to show your toys. Whatever your toy presentation is what you're going to show here as well. Then you can have your multiple orgasms, and then you can go ahead and talk about those enhancement creams again. Enhancement. All right. Creams again right through here to kind of keep everything going all over again. And then last but not least, then you have your resolution, which is you're giving your pillow some head, right? So that is where your resolution kind of comes into play. So you can actually, I used to do this at my parties, is I always talk about the sexual response cycle and actually go through each section and say, okay, now, anybody remember what the next section was? And then be like excitement stage. And then we would talk about the products. Anybody remember what the next section was? Your plateau. These are the products that's going to help in that plateau stage. So it really kind of helps pinpoint maybe where they need help with in their relationship or what's going on in their bedroom. So, and then of course at the end, you can come back and talk about between the sheets again, because now that you've climaxed or even have your multiple orgasms, whose side's the wet spot on? Hours, right? So you can always revert back to your between the sheets as far as like a closing in your in here. So that is your sexual response cycle and how you can incorporate your parties into it. So let's now, shit, I didn't record any of this. Oh wait, yeah, I did. Okay, never mind. All right, so let's go ahead and start with your questions.
I have a client. It's more concerned about her husband. He's a diabetic, and he has trouble getting an erection. So what's the best thing to really tell her? I said a lot of foreplay was going to really, and like, you know, tell him it's going to be okay kind of thing.
What would really help him out with that?
Well, that's more of a, like a medical issue type thing. So there's, I mean, foreplay, he's going to really probably have to take that under control, get his diabetes under control for things to kind of work. As far as keeping an erection, though, the O can help keep the erection, but it's not going to get him the erection. So as far as if he's having a hard time getting the erection, he really needs to really kind of get that under control in order to get there. So Miss Nurse Keisha has something that she wants to say.
Why you gotta put me on the spot like that?
Because you're like nodding your head frantically.
Yeah, I was saying hi to Duke too, because he was behind you. Yeah, they're gonna have to. He's gonna have to get his blood sugar under control, and that's something they need to consult. And actually, I know he's a man, and some men don't like to talk to their doctors, but he has to talk to his doctor and say, "We're having this issue. What medically do I need to do before we can, you know, be intimate and before I can get an erection?" And maybe with his diabetes, they can give him something to take with that, but they'll have to control his blood sugar first. So I would refer back to the doctor. I don't want to tell her one of our products are going to work or they're not, and it not help them.
Yeah, that's what I told her. I'm like, I'm not going to, I say foreplay, and she'd end up buying like Whip, and I guess they've went to the doctor before and had pills and stuff. So I that's what I told her. I'm like, I'm not a doctor, so right. I can't really tell you, hey, this is what's going to help. Yeah,
I would just, they would have to see the doctor and try to, you know, do more foreplay and try to do that and get it. It might be an emotional thing too. And like I said, it might be that he needs to control his blood sugar a little bit better before they do get intimate.
Okay.
Another option.
So, all right.